So let's take a look at using wildcards in Numbers. Wildcards allow you to compare strings, but specify that you don't care what a particular character or group of characters is. For instance, say here we've got a table with product sales. We've got products with names like A0012, A0016, etc. And say we want to get the total for a certain product or group of products. So I can do a sum if formula here. So I'll put a formula here, sum if, and then we'll take column A here, so product sales A, and what we'll do is we'll compare that to A0012. I put quotes around this, and that will return true in two cases here, in two rows, and we'll say when it's true we're going to take the values in column B. And the result is 9 because we have this first row here is A0012 and it's a 4, and this one A0012 and it's a 5, and that is a total of 9. But let's say we want to total up all of the products that start with A00. Well, we could do that using the same formula here, but instead of 12 we can put question mark question mark, and that means for those characters that are question marks it could be any character. So now when I use that formula you can see I get 18. It matches all of those because they all start with A except for the fifth row here. So 4 plus 6 plus 3 plus 5 is 18. It's not including the 7 there. Now I could make this a little bit better. I could say I don't care what the number is. So I'm going to be 4 question marks instead of the 4 digits that are there. I could also use the asterisk, which is shift and then the 8 on American keyboards. And this says any number of characters after it. So I do that. It's going to give me the same result, but it would give me the same result say if I mistyped or if there was a product here that was A016. So only 3 characters after it. It doesn't matter how many are after it. So that gives me the ability to basically kind of do an OR type of function here inside of a sum if. And I can get results like give me everything that's got a product name starting with A. Now you can use all sorts of different things with these. You can say asterisk A asterisk, which would mean anything that contains the letter A or anything that contains the word apple. You can also do like question mark question mark, so the first 2 characters don't matter and then the next 4 need to be test, and then there needs to be you know, just anything after it. So you can use any combinations of question marks and asterisks to indicate one or many different characters there. So you can play around with that. It might be useful if you ever need to indicate that a character is the real thing. In other words, you're actually looking for an asterisk. Then what you want to do is use the tilde character, the shift and the key right above the tab. And if you use that with an asterisk or a question mark, it basically says use that exact character. And you can combine this with the values in cells. So for instance, I can say A here and B here, and I can create a sum if and do this column, and the value I'm looking for is the value here, and then use the ampersand to concatenate strings and say asterisk. So anything A and then an asterisk, a wildcard after it, and then give me the total here in B. And that gives me 18 there. If I copy and paste here it's going to give me 7. So this is looking for anything starting with A. This is looking for anything starting with B. Now you can only use wildcards in certain specific functions. If you do a search in the Numbers help for wildcard, you can find a page that lists functions that accept the conditions as arguments, and you can see several of them here. Things like, you know, average if, count if, H lookup, match, search, and V lookup. So there's only a few certain functions that accept this, but if you use those and you need to do this kind of thing, it's very useful and very versatile.